Today, I finally have a really good M13 class setup for you guys to try. I've been seeing you guys request this in the comments for quite some time now. So I finally went ahead and got around to making the most balanced M13 class setup. This one features a pretty good balance between being stealthy, mobility, as well as range. And of course, we all know the M13 has zero recoil on it. And that's why a lot of people prefer using the M13 because of its user friendliness. So without further ado, let's just get into the class setup really quick. So for the muzzle, of course, we are rocking that monolithic suppressor. Me being a stealthy type of player, I like to be as undetected as possible, and having that sound suppression is going to be huge as well. And also the damage range increase is also nice. So for the next attachment, we are going to want to use the Tempest Marksman barrel. This one is going to give us the most amount of damage range and the best recoil control we could possibly have. And as you can see, I'm not running an under barrel at all. It's not needed, quite frankly, on the M13. This gun is pretty much a laser right out the box. You don't really need to do much to it for it to have zero recoil. So adding on an under barrel, long story short, is not necessary at all. You can use that attachment slot for something else that's actually worthwhile. So for the stock, we're gonna have a little bit of flexibility here. And I do wanna point out that it really just depends on what kind of map you're on. So if you're on a larger map where the lines of sight are a lot longer and you're most likely gonna engage in long range combat, I would definitely recommend putting on that M13 skeleton stock, because this one's gonna give you that aim walking movement speed as well as aim down sight speed. So when you're in those long range gunfights, it will help you to strafe left and right when you're engaging in long range gunfights. Now, if you're on a smaller map or a map where it's mostly close quarter and a lot of your engagements are gonna be at close range to medium range, you definitely wanna run with the no stock attachment. So always pay attention to what map you're about to get on and then make the switch accordingly between the two stocks, because the no stock is gonna give you more movement speed as well as aim down sight speed. And that's gonna be very important for those close quarter combat situations. So moving on to the rear grip, we're using that stippled grip tape. We need to have more mobility on this weapon. So having the stippled grip tape on definitely does mitigate the negative effects of the attachments that do hinder our aim down sight speed. For our ammunition, we're gonna be running with the 60 round magazine. That about wraps it up for the M13 class setup. The next portion of this video will feature a breakdown using this exact same class setup and how I use it to its advantages to make sure that I'm able to do well in game, as well as share some tactics that you guys can apply to your own game as well, and hopefully learn something new from it. If you guys do end up enjoying this video, make sure to drop a like on this video. And if you're new to the channel, make sure to subscribe today. Join Turbo Nation, make it official. And I will see you guys in the gameplay. Peace. All right, so here we are. We're playing on Talisk Backlot. I mean, let's be real here, not one of the best maps in the game. That's why I'm bringing you this gameplay today, just to show you how you can play on a pretty campy map such as this. So the first thing that you always want to consider is which parts of the map will you die less from? What are the factors are you going to die from? And how can you minimize those variables to get killed from? So the simple answer on Talisk Backlot is, of course, sticking to the outskirts of the map. And I'm pretty sure y'all knew that was coming. And you never really want to run down the middle of the map, because look at how many buildings there are on this map. And it's just not a smart idea. And you know, that's just the reality of it. You have to hold down areas. And that's pretty much what I'm going to be doing today. So as you can see, I'm pretty much just picking one side of the map that I do want to patrol. Now, I'm not just going to be sitting in corners. You know, I'm not going to be playing that way, because you know, those kind of players, they quite frankly don't get better at the game. And it's just a toxic kind of play style, if you ask me. So the only reason why that I'm here in the middle is because I wanted to navigate to this part of the map once again a little bit safer. Now, I didn't just stick out like a sore thumb. I stuck to the walls, pretty much just hugging the walls. That's as best as I can explain it. Now, here I am on the construction side of the building, and what I'm doing here is I'm kind of patrolling their spawn, because I'm looking at the minimap right now. So if I pause it right here, as you can see, all of my teammates are on the opposite side of the map. I'm here all alone. So that means that my chances of coming across some enemies are that much higher. And the whole theory behind flanking is that I'm going to be able to get some easy kills of the enemies from behind, because the enemies are just way too busy being distracted by my teammates, which are seen here. And as you can see, some of them are engaging in a gunfight right now. So in this particular area, this is where the enemies are going to be spawning in from, because usually enemies spawn in the areas that are not inhabited by your own teammates. So if I keep playing here, I'm going to pre-aim down here just to be sure that I'm going to win that gunfight. And this is where I'm assuming there are going to be enemies. Now, as you can see, there are plenty of footsteps here that lead this way, but instead of going this way, I'm going to take the safer route, and I'm going to come on top of these cars right here. I'm going to go through this window. This is actually one of my favorite ways to go ahead ahead and flank people. And unfortunately, there were not any enemies that were here in this area. But you know, more often than not, if you're flanking and your teammates are on the opposite side, there most likely are going to be enemies in this area right here in this taxi building, and you might be able to get a flank. Now, this gives me a good vantage point of the enemies that possibly have their backs turned to me. And as you can see here, I come up on a kill here, and he had no idea that I was going to be here. Now, here's the most important part. So if you're on this part of the map by yourself, you always want to go ahead and look outside of this window, because the enemies are going to be spawning in from this area right here. Now, as you can see, there is an enemy that did pop out here, and this gives me a huge advantage because, number one, I've got the hide advantage, and secondly, I'm just overlooking their spawn right now. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to come out here again. So the reason why I come out here is because I want to keep pushing forward and minimize the areas that they do spawn in. So you're going to see me just pre-aim here as I'm pushing down. And as you can see, I did come up on an enemy kill right here, and another one popped up right there. So that's why it's always important not to rush the spawns. You always want to be patient. Just pre-aim from where you're at. Do not rush it, because the enemies will appear and come towards you. Now, as you can see, I did come up on another easy kill. 100% this guy most likely spawned in this area. So the spawns are surely soon to flip. And how I know this is because I've got teammates that are moving in this area. Obviously, I've got this area inhabited, so the enemies are no longer going to be spawning in here. So I've got my white phosphorus. That's my Q that I only need two more kills to get this advanced UAV. So I'm going to play as cautious as I possibly can. So as I move down here, I'm going to pre-aim down every line of sight where it's possible that I could get shot from. I'm also keeping an eye on that minimap. Now, this is a really interesting part right here. I dropped down right away and I was able to get the kill. We could all say that was 100% luck based, you know, but you know, call it what you want. I still got the kill, and I was fortunate enough to jump off the ladder in time to be able to kill that guy. So let me just back it up here really quickly. So this is a small little detail that maybe you guys can apply to your game, is that every time I come up these stairs, I don't really just go up these stairs with my back turned to the second level part. You know, I always turn around right here. Because when you're turning around right here, this gives you a good idea of what's up here, first of all, so you don't have your back turned when you're going up the stairs. And also at the same time, it allows you to see enemies who might be flanking you from behind, such as this guy was right here. That's exactly why I was able to get that guy. So I call in my advanced UAV right away, and then I call in my white phosphorus. This is absolutely crucial if you're running the white phosphorus in tandem with the advanced UAV, because number one, it gives you a good clear idea of where the enemies are. Obviously, all you got to do is look at your minimap, and it will tell you where they're moving in real time. And at the same time, the white phosphorus, it basically makes the enemies one shot. So here I'm going to pre-aim and pre-fire into their spawn. I'm just making the connection with the dots on the minimap as well as what I see in front of me. And now I'm on a Ruthless, so I'm looking to capitalize and take advantage of the advanced UAV. I'm not sure how long it's up in the air. I'm guessing maybe 45 seconds. So I want to take advantage of this, but at the same time, I do not want to risk being killed off of my streak. So here I'm going to play a little bit more campy, because you know, I'm not sure where these guys are coming from. And look at that recoil, man. There is absolutely no recoil on the M13. You know, no matter how you configure it, it's just a laser from distance. And that's why I really like this specific class setup. It's able to compete from short to long range, and it's very competitive. So as you can see right there, I was able to get a kill. It was a pretty risky kill, but I was confident enough to get the kill nonetheless. Now right here is where I'm pretty much just pushing it. If, you know, looking back on this gameplay, if I could have done this better, I probably would have rotated and got a different angle on the enemy spawn instead of just staying here, because at this point the enemies know that I'm camping here in this building. And I know earlier I said, you know, you don't want to just sit in a corner and camp, because those kind of people don't get better. The last few kills that I've gotten, they all just kept appearing in their spawn, and I've got the hide advantage up here. So what's the point of just, you know, moving around if the enemies are literally spawning in front of your face? So here's where the enemy spawns have flipped. Now, you're probably wondering, how did I know that? So my cue from this point on was, I'm looking at the minimap, I'm looking at how many teammates I have in their spawn. So this is where they previously were spawning in. So I've got a couple teammates here, 100% for sure the spawns have flipped. So that's why I go ahead and make the adjustment to turn myself around and look into the other part of the spawn. I'm approaching very cautiously. I'm going to pre-aim around this corner just so I can get the upper hand in that gunfight. So now I'm on a 20. I see this guy coming over here, and I was able to go ahead and strafe in that gunfight to be able to win. Now, I almost die here, so I don't have any more stim shots, so that's why I back into a corner momentarily to allow myself to heal up just a little bit. Here I am again. I'm in their spawn. I'm going to pre-aim again, and I'm gonna basically do the same thing. Now, this is where I switch it up just a little bit because I see that my teammate is going upstairs here. He's engaging in a gunfight. I did see the lines outside of the triangle. So what I decide to do is I actually decide to go from underneath here instead of going from the back way over here because I kind of want to cover more ground. I just want to make sure there's no enemies on the first floor of this house. And that's why I decided to go here instead. Now he died, so I'm going to be pre-aiming as I go up these stairs and I was able to get the kill. So I'm on a 22 right now. Again, I'm looking to capitalize. Maybe I could possibly get a nuke. Now I'm going to turn my attention into this direction right here, just like I did earlier in the video. So I'm going to be pre-aiming here. Now I'm going to come down here. This is where they're most likely going to be spawning in from. Now I'm seeing some gunfire right here. Right here. That indicates that there is an enemy over there. So that's why I went ahead. You know what? I said, screw it. Let me go ahead and try to kill this guy. Unfortunately, he wasn't there. And my teammate actually distracted me. I thought that was an enemy. So that's why I momentarily looked that way. And unfortunately, this enemy was able to kill me because I was so distracted by my teammate. So, you know, it's really unfortunate that I didn't get the nuke there, but you know, nonetheless, we stayed alive for as long as we possibly can by making sure that we're rotating around the map accordingly, we're filling in those lanes correctly, and we're also taking precautions. See, again, I go up these stairs. Like I said before, do not ever go up those stairs with your back turned to the second floor. What you're about to see here is a sequence of unneeded deaths. At this point, I was actually kind of thrown off at the fact that I could have gotten a nuke. So I just really didn't care anymore. I just wanted the game to end. There's less than 10 kills left in the game. So I just kind of want to talk about this map once again. Like I said, I just want to recap. If you're playing on this map, always remember to stay on the outskirts. If you're just running down the middle and you have no direction, then you're most likely going to get killed from different directions that you don't even know where it's coming in from. And that's a mindset that you always want to come into when you're playing on this map or any kind of similar maps out there, is have a plan. If you have a strategy, that minimizes the chances of you dying to unneeded deaths. And that's exactly what I like about running strategies versus just running around like you're a chicken with its head cut off, is that the probabilities that you will do better is much higher. So that's why I always try to show my strategies as much as I possibly can so that it can possibly help out you guys out there. I mean, my gun skill is not that great. You know, it could be better. And that's why I use my strengths to my advantages, which is my Call of Duty IQ, if you want to say that. You know, I've got really great map knowledge. I know which positions in the map will give me the best percentage of winning certain gunfights. It's all about map awareness as well and making sure you're using the weapon to its best potential. All right, so the final moments of the game are approaching. There's only one kill left. And that is about it. Yeah, and you know what, guys? Like, if you're new to my channel and you're thinking like, man, this gameplay is so boring, I'm here to help you guys get better. If I were to show you guys something like 100 plus kills against bots, you know, that you're literally not going to learn anything. We finished off with 24 kills, 5 deaths. I hope you guys did learn something in this episode. If you did, let me know down below in the comments, and hope you guys do better in Talisk Backlot. And drop a like on this video if you want to see more breakdowns such as this. And subscribe if you're new around here. If you want to make your way back to the channel, join Turbo Nation today. Make it official. Thank you for 95,000 subscribers, man. I really appreciate it. It really means a lot to me. So that's about it for me. I hope you guys have a good day, and I will see you guys in the next video. Peace.